I'm Audrey Dubot-Perez. I'm a virologist from IRD, and I am based in Marseille at the Unit of Emerging Viruses at Faculty of Medicine. And I am supervising the virology activity at Lom Ru in Laos. So dengue virus infection is an important health problem in Laos, with infection all over the years and epidemic during the rainy season. So the most serious epidemic was in 2013 with more than 40,000 reported cases and 95 deaths. But it's not only in a urban area, but there is also evidence of dengue infections in rural areas. And but few data are available, and some investigations are developing, and we hope that we could provide more data in a near future, especially from provinces. Yes, lack of confirmed data is a problem, as I say, for we don't have, we need to have really accurate data based on confirmed laboratory testing, and it's really a problem because the facilities are only in Vientiane capital. So we have, I'd say most of the data are coming from the capital, so we have really a lack of data, especially from the rural area and the provinces. So we don't have a whole picture of what happened in the country, and it's really limited to capital with some data from some provinces. In Marseille, we have a diagnosis platform where we develop and we validated the molecular testing, like a real-time PCR, and we develop a format which is a freeze-dry format that we can send at room temperature to Laos, and all the different testing for the different virus are in the same format. So this is really easy to use for the team in Laos, and we also provide some quality control so we can control the result in Laos. So we are involved in viruses that are of important health problem in Laos, which include, as I say, dengue virus, but also the viruses that causes central nervous system infection. And we did a long-term study on this, and we set up diagnosis service at Maustad Hospital. So we provide support for diagnosis on central nervous system infection and on arboviruses. The main arboviruses that causes encephalitis is Japanese encephalitis virus. Our study provides the first data on the incidence of Japanese encephalitis in Laos, and this was a key information for the implementation of JV vaccination in Laos. For me, the most significant advances in our research was the development of a new innovative technology for pathogen detection and characterization, as for example, the RDTs, which are easy to use and don't require laboratory facilities. And this is they are of important added value because they can be used in the community in rural area. However, they need to be validated in the environmental and epidemiological context they will be used. And this is what we did for dengue RDT. And we show that the brain that we tested remain efficient even after long-term storage at tropical temperature. So I think that our research matters because we are studying infectious disease and that can be fatal. And whereas some are preventable, so our work, in fact, could save life. And I will give an example. In the framework of this study, we set up a cerebrospinal diagnosis service at Maustad Hospital. And we did the first diagnosis of herpes simplex encephalitis on a young kid and who could receive the appropriate treatment and survive. I would say that our research is in fact driven by translational medicine, because we are studying the causes of infectious disease in Laos to adapt diagnosis and treatment and to inform health policy in Laos to decrease infectious disease burden. The Japanese encephalitis data that we provide that were key information to implement the vaccination. Many other things that need to be discovered in Laos, and we don't know. We know only a small part of the full picture, and I think that there is plenty of research that need to be done in Laos and not only in Vientiane capital.